I have to disclose this. She made really good.
The most awaited question. How much salary do you get? Come.
Guys, who said women cannot be seafarers? So welcome back to another day at sea, and today we have a very special lady, and she's on board Emma Mers. She just joined 10 days back, and she will introduce herself. So
hello guys, this is Romita Bundela, and I am electrotechnical officer on board Emma Mers, and I am the first lady, Indian lady officer,
yes,
in Mers.
So guys, first Indian lady technical officer, and it's a pleasure to have you on board. So she'll be showing us around what she does as an ETO on board, and a lot of you wanted to see what exactly the role of an electrical officer is. So she will show us today, and let's see what we have in the bag. So guys, Romita, she will show us around what's going to happen exactly. She's basically in charge of all the reefers here, and all the reefers, and on this ship we have a reefer capacity of
1,000
reefers, guys. 1,000 containers. I'll show you. We'll go on one container today.
Yeah.
So container. She'll be showing us one container of reefer, what she does exactly during her daily checks.
Yeah, daily checks.
Luckily, we don't have many reefers right now.
Yeah, now we have 72. So it's not much, but
not much.
We can still.
But when she joined the ship, there were
900 plus
reefers, and she was with another cadet who just joined. So she had to take care of all the reefers, and we had some malfunction as well, which she sorted out. So guys, this is not an easy job. Definitely it requires a lot of physical work.
Yeah.
And I don't know, whoever said that women cannot do physical work are totally wrong, because I have seen her do it personally, and believe me, everything works smoothly. So no issues at all. So guys, before proceeding for the reefers, let's ask her a few questions. How our day starts. So Romita, what time do you start generally?
Morning 8 o'clock.
So morning 8, and then entire day,
yeah,
you are checking reefers and something else?
Yeah. First we have to check reefers, then we have engine room jobs.
Okay.
And then lighting system, of course.
So guys, for those who are Hindi viewers, sometimes we call them Batti Saab. And Batti Saab basically lights or everything related to lights are done by Romita and all the, you know,
wherever there is fire, there is ETO job.
Wherever
as
there is fire,
simple as that.
And wherever there is skull and there is high voltage sign,
yeah, that is
again
also ETO job.
And
yeah,
she is also assisting the engineers with,
yeah,
all the electrical works which are required. So we'll see what all we got covered today. But most important job she has is the reefers.
Yeah. Primary job is reefer.
Because they are like a high value cargo.
Yeah.
So they need to be monitored.
Actually, we have 4 high value units right now.
Okay. So
yeah,
so that have to be checked every 8 hours or something.
Yeah, three times a day. We have to send readings as well.
And so guys, as you must have seen, the cargo holds are deep over here, and she has to go 3 times maybe up and down, right?
Yeah.
For some of the reefers, right? That is a challenge, guys. Believe me, I get tired personally even 1 time. So 3 times. So
three times.
Yeah, good job, guys. Okay guys, so we are here at the reefer, and we will ask Romita what all she checks in her day on the reefer. So Romita, could you just tell us a little bit?
Yeah, so this is our reefer container.
Okay.
Basically it is now frozen container. We frozen, chilled, special kind of cargo as well. So this is a frozen one.
Okay.
Here what we see in daily round is if it is in range or not.
Okay.
So this green light should be on always.
Okay.
And for special cargo, we check supply return as well.
Then Romita, can you show us little bit parts of what all parts we have?
So this is a display.
Okay.
And behind that is controller.
Okay.
Condenser fan.
Okay.
And heart of the reefer is compressor.
So that's the heart of the reefer.
Yeah.
That's the compressor.
That's the compressor.
Okay.
This is receiver.
Okay.
And freon is stored.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
dryer.
So
pump evaporator.
That's the
evaporators inside them.
Two of them.
So guys, as you saw, that was some of the reefer parts, but the most important thing, sometimes the problems are real. And suppose there's a compressor, like you saw, it's heavy, maybe 20-30 kilos.
Yeah,
30 kilos. So how do you change this? Like, you have to physically pick it up and put it here?
Yeah, exactly. We have to, like that. Once we have to disconnect the old one.
Okay.
And then we have to take it out, then put new one.
Okay.
So connecting and disconnecting is much easier, but yeah. The only thing is,
so guys, as you heard, it's not so easy changing all the components, so again, physical work is definitely required. So do you know what is inside the reefer?
Commodity.
So I guess only reefers and dangerous cargo, we know what's inside the container.
Yeah.
But rest, all of this, we have no idea. So guys, we are at the station where Romita has all her spare parts. It's known as the reefer workshop, and we'll ask her what all she has over here. So Romita, okay, you take over. What is all this?
These are Freon bottles.
Okay.
R134. We have two types.
Okay.
134 and 404. So some reefers use this gas and some this one.
Okay.
These are connectors.
So these are the connectors.
Yeah.
So Romita, what is Freon used for?
For cooling down the unit.
So this is used in our normal,
like a blood in human drink.
So it's the circulation. Okay, that's the right word. And this is the same used in our home aircon.
Same refrigeration.
It's okay. Same Freon. So guys, same aircon which you have in your room is same thing which we have over here, which are used in the reefer.
Only thing is this system is big one, and at home we have small system.
Okay. And then Romita, what all do you use from here? Like,
this one is for star cool. We have basically star cool, Deccan,
okay,
Thermoking, four kind of companies.
Four companies, yeah. Then I can see some tube lights and lights, which we have a big major project here of changing the lights.
Every day,
because it's such a big ship and every day light gets busted, you know. So
2 to 3 packets
every day.
And one is containing 50 tube lights.
So when there's no reefer, then there's more of light work and all of that, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So hey, that is the compressor we were talking about, which weighs more than 30 kgs. I just tried to pick it up, no chance. So we need 2-3 guys for sure. So those are the spares which are kept, and they have to transfer it whenever there is some fault in the reefer. So yeah, it's a tough job, guys. And Romita, how do you monitor these from the computer? Like,
yeah, RCM. We have a remote control monitoring system,
okay,
for reefer. So we can monitor
from the computer. So guys, we are now going inside the battery locker where there's all the reserve batteries for everything, like the GMDSS equipment and everything. And she'll be doing her test today, so let's see how it goes. Romita will explain to us what all these batteries are for exactly. Romita is also having work here on the deck when the chief officer requires her. So generally, Romita, you're working here with the
mooring winches.
Okay, with the mooring winch. Okay, so
basically this is the motor.
Okay.
We have to do insulation test.
Okay.
This is 6 monthly.
Okay. And
air gap, which is mechanical part actually.
Okay.
So we have to check air gap.
You're checking that also.
Brake linings.
So guys, as you can see, deck work, engine work, reefer work, and
everywhere.
Cooking work. Oh, by the way guys, I have to disclose this. She made really good food for us on 2 Sundays now, right?
Yeah, back to
one was chicken and one was this Indian style dal roti and sabji, guys. Thank you Romita for that also. So guys, 4 types of work she's managing it all alone, being a only a female seafarer we have right now on board. And thank you once again, Romita.
So guys, we are back inside the accommodation, and Romita, thank you once again for showing us around. And I'm a total noob. I didn't understand. I'm sure you must have understood more than me. But yes, that was a good day I spent with the electrical officer. So I know something about electrical things also. But that's besides the point. I'll ask you a few questions, Romita, before ending this. First question I had was, how long is your contract here?
It's 5 plus minus 1.
So 6 months. Due to COVID?
Due to COVID now. Maybe more than that, 6 months.
Guys, this is the hard tragedy we have these days, that the sign-on, sign-off has been a big task. Companies trying to do their best, but because of the world closure, lockdown, I'm sure it's a tough job for them as well.
Yes.
But okay, then do you have some holidays in between on the ship? Like, do you get some off?
Yeah, on papers we have, but we don't have. We don't have any weekends as well.
Sometimes
we have to work Saturdays, Sundays.
Every day is a work day. That's the truth, guys. You are on the ship, you are like on job 24 hours.
Yeah, exactly.
You can be called anytime. I don't know if that's a pro or con, but that's how it is. Okay, Romita, the most awaited question. How much salary do you get?
It's between $4,000 and $5,000.
That's the industrial standard.
Yeah, it's a standard.
So guys, $4,000 to $5,000, that's as per the industry standard. It depends on the seniority and everything, right?
Yeah, and depends on type of ship as well.
Type of ship.
On tankers, we have much more.
On tankers,
6,000 plus even. Chemical tankers, LNG, LPG, they have 8,000.
But then the health issues are also there, right?
Yeah.
That's the thing. So in any case, guys, if you found this video informative and got some good insight, then don't forget to
like and subscribe.
Guys. Thank you, guys. See you back with another video.